What is up, you guys? So I know this is not the live video that I promised for today. Life got in the way and just gonna have to deal with a regular video this time. So sorry about it. I will do the one that I promised, like probably tomorrow, but life got in the way and you know, sometimes you gotta do what you gotta do. And today, what I gotta do is a pre-recorded video. So we're gonna go over some of these Bling It's from Resin Art, which you can't even see because I don't know how to work the cameras like B does. So hopefully I figured it out. Let's get to it. I don't know if I have these on the website yet, but if I don't, I'll have them on the website tonight. I've seen Leslie do some pretty cool things with them. I haven't investigated them myself, as well as the like interference colors. There's so many. There's not enough hours in the day for me to play with every color that comes through the doors. Not complaining. I love it. But then I also love my favorite colors, so I don't know. Let's get things started. And before you guys think that I'm drinking resin, I just don't want to ruin one of my favorite glasses. So I'm going to put that bad boy over there. Tink. All right. So the resin that we're going to use today is Shocker Art Coat from Stone Coat Countertops. This is my favorite resin right now, and I could go on and on about the reasons, but if you've seen any of my videos recently, then you know that it's just a bad A resin. I don't want to put the whole bad word in there, but you know. If you've tried it, you know. We'll put it that way. You know, then you know. So I think I'm gonna use about 6 ounces for this canvas. I'm pretty sure it's a 10 by 20 something. I'm not mathing or measuring today. Then again, when do I? But yeah, sorry about that siren. And if you're new to resin, you just have to mix this up till it runs clear, which is about 3 minutes. So this is the boring part. If I had like Kardashian money, I would hire someone to mix my resin for sure. How funny is that? Of all the things I would pay for, that's the one I went with. Resin mixer. Any of you guys are in Dallas and want to intern, please apply within. Supplies provided. Isn't that how that works? I don't know. It's so different. Excuse me, talking to a camera without Jeff being right here to interact with, or you guys being in cyber world to chat with. Anyways, so you need to mix this fully, because if you don't, you're gonna end up with a very sad day, because either your piece will set too fast or it won't set at all. Very first piece I ever did never set at all. Like, I held on to it for, had to have been at least 3 months. I was just being sad watching it. I checked on it every day. Never set up. It was sad. Jeff finally was like, you gotta throw that away. And he was right, and so I did. I just love sharing heartwarming tales with you guys. So, when you mix your resin, if you're a first timer, make sure you scrape the bottom, the sides, and your stir stick as well. This will help to incorporate the A and the B parts fully. Because if you don't, you may end up with a weak spot that won't set, so then you have to dig that out, put alcohol, and then do a flood coat. Hopefully the weak part isn't in the middle of like one of your favorite parts of your piece, but it always is. If you've ever had that happen, you know that the weak spot is always where you would least want it to be. I hope that makes sense. Apparently words are also difficult for me today, but what's new?
Nothing.
All right. So I don't know exactly the best way to like showcase these Bling It colors, but what I'm planning on doing is doing like a whole bunch of blues, like darker colors, but I'm also gonna incorporate like a powder, a tint, a paste, a base tint, just to see how they react in all the different options. We'll use amethyst, that sounds good. So I'm gonna use Stormy Seas. It's a dark blue. Is this new? It's a dark blue paste from Color Obsession. It's one of my favorites. When people ask me, I guess I should put resin in here first. What the best like deep part of the ocean color would be, it would be this. It's kind of like a deep purpley blue color. It looks black on, I don't know if you guys can see this. Where are you? There you are. See the thinner areas, you can see kind of the true color, but you'll see it in the resin anyway, so I don't know what I'm even talking about. Blathering? Let me know below. Is it blabbering or blathering? Because I don't know. Words. So these epoxy pastes mix in. You can kind of see it really good there. Wait. My hand's in the way. I think I have my camera situated kind of like upside down and backwards. Anyways, I carry these colors in our online store. Hit us up if you're in the market for some paste or pigment powders that are specifically designed for resin, epoxy, etc. It makes a difference, I'm telling you. Next color I'm using is Turquoise by Color Obsession. It's not the deep turquoise that I usually favor, and that's because I already have so many dark colors going on in this piece. I don't want to darken it too much. I want to have some light areas, you know? If you use usually like acrylic paints in your resin, then you know the cautionary tale about not adding too much paint into your resin. And typically the rule is 10% pigment to resin in general. With like tints and inks, you can kind of push that boundary a little bit. So the next color is Color Obsession Turquoise. This is a powder. I just love the way this kind of powder shimmers. It's almost holographic. Almost, not completely. But it's like a beautiful light blue color with like this green shimmer in it. Magic. All right, now I'm gonna use Amethyst by Color. This is gonna be an all Color Obsession piece. Usually I have one just resin mixed into the mix. Who am I? And maybe I still will. They have beautiful colors as well. Oop, that was fun. With these tints, you don't have to add that much, and they usually come with a pipette, which I just have not added to that because I'm a rock star and I just didn't. You don't want to add too much of the tint. It's not going to thicken it. It'll just thin it a lot. And I'm not really sure what would happen if you do. The tints are all transparent. That took away some of my gesso. Maybe I'll explore that idea later. So let's do some Bling Its. Let's do... I've never used the oyster one. I haven't used any of these. Let's do the Bling It Gold. Because y'all know I like to incorporate some gold into my pieces. So it's super shimmery, sparkly. definitely works with that Bling It label it comes with. And I am way sure that I just overloaded that a little bit, but yellow, etc. I put a little bit more resin on top of that to make sure it doesn't just puff up in my face when I go to mix it. When you mix powders, you really want to make sure you have some kind of like protection. You don't want to breathe micas. It's not good for your health. And I have a little bit of clear left. I'm just going to drop in some Stone Coat base tint. This, you don't have to use a lot when you use this stuff, but I want to see what the Bling It does with Stone Coat. So how did purple get in there? My life, that's how. All right, so that's mixed in well. And usually I have something on the base of my canvas to make my colors glide over the surface more easily, but I didn't make enough resin. So instead I'm just gonna use some of these to kind of put a thin layer down. This canvas was a painting. I didn't like it, didn't sell, so I decided to paint over it, and so that's what we're doing. I just spray painted it back to white. So the positive of that is it's more sturdy. Look at that gradient. It's almost like working with oil paints, and that like I can get a nice fade between one color to the next. From one color to the next, y'all. I'm not wording well today. We're working on switching around our studio a little bit. We're gonna put our bedroom where our office is, and our office where our bedroom is.
Are you live?
No, it's recorded. I'm recording, and I'm just gonna post the recording. So, okay. A little bit dark on camera. It's not gonna show teals anyways. So I don't know. See if I can brighten this up a little bit.
Let me see.
I haven't just made just not enough resin, but we will see how it goes.
Get that white, that doesn't show that teal. That's just so pretty. That's such a great color. It doesn't even show up.
I don't really have a plan for this. I'm just kind of adding color because it's not so much a design piece as it is a test of certain products piece. Right, so we got some color down. Let's add some heat, maybe.
You could get so much closer if you turn it sideways.
My face was right there. Alright. I don't want to add too much heat, so let's get some wiping paper. These I also have available on my website, but you guys, you can make it on your own with some like parchment paper.
Just regular paper if you don't.
Could
it doesn't
use
slide over
paper.
as easy, and you can't wipe it off like that.
This definitely has a gloss to it, so it makes reusing easier, but definitely don't feel like you're married to the idea of you have to purchase it from me. You can definitely make your own. However, if you don't feel like doing it by yourself, you can always get them from me. I'm just kind of wiping the residue, the leftover, back onto the piece so that it's not like a waste of product. And it is very cold here today, so this is not moving easy. Let's heat it up just a little bit. Now you can use a torch or a heat gun, whatever you're more comfortable with. Don't just think because it's a heat gun, it's safer. I burnt myself with a heat gun and not a torch. So just put that in your brain. Right. Love this torch because it comes with this attachment and I can kind of push and maneuver the resin. Makes me happy when I can do that. I have a link to it in our Amazon store, which is in the description box below if you're interested. If not, it's cool. I love this dark area. I think it gives it a little bit of a balance since it's so busy. And there's this gradual fade up here. Resin. And there's something trying to live in my piece, so I'm gonna try to get that out. It's a Cujo hair, of course. Those are prevalent in our house. So now I have this Bling It gold and it's super sparkly. It's super radiant. Radiant? Let's go with radiant. Just gonna put a line right through here. Oh. It's a dazzler. How fun is that? I'll answer my question for you. Super fun. So now let's add a little bit more of it through here. And put some of this teal next to it so I can like maneuver one over the other and see if we can come up with some really neat designs. Need to add some heat. Let's get our swiping paper out. Voila. This Bling It is not joking with its name. It's not a drill. It is super blingy. Ooh, it like glows under that purple. But I probably already have, because that's my life in the crazy lane. So I'm digging it, but I need it to like move well with the piece. So I want to tilt it just a bit so that it's like fully incorporated and it makes sense. Because if I just added those lines and just left it, it may not make that much sense. But if I add the lines and tilt it, then it'll have a consistent and fluid movement in the piece. So there we go. I'm gonna do a video of this and put it in the ATD's Poor People group so that you guys can see the true colors, because of course, as per usual, my camera's like, I don't like teal or purple, so everything's gonna live in the blue. Whatever. So, I'm gonna go ahead and post a video for you guys in the Poor People's group. You'll probably see that before you see this actual whole video, but YOLO. I made it in. It's because I'm a part-time rock star, so whatever. Thank you guys for tuning in, watching, seeing what I'm up to. Look how orange my hand is. This is so much more accurate to my actual skin tone. Life. Anyways, let me give you guys some things to read. Here's your homework. Wait for it. There you go. Read all these things. Check us out in different avenues of the World Wide Web. And if you're interested in any of these colors, I'll have the Bling It's up tonight/tomorrow. And if you guys won the drawing, I'm going to be putting those in tonight/tomorrow. So Lori, Diane, and there's one more. This is not them. Mary Crushing Harris. I'll be having those live in a minute. Hi, Moose. Cujo got a haircut today. Come here. He looks adorable as ever. Oh, I know it, Moose. You're the cutest one. Anyways, thanks you guys for tuning in. I will see you tomorrow for a live video at 8 p.m. Central Standard, United States of America time. Dallas, Texas is where we are, so Google that to know when we're going live in your time zone. And, yeah. Thanks for watching, y'all. Be kind to one another. You never know what someone may be going through. Bye.
I said bye.